team. He's trying to learn a new defensive scheme, and it's all being thrown at him fast and furious. But he's the type of guy who can thrive in a situation like this, and I expect him to do just that.
A run there on first down gets three up to the 28.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he's trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. Oh, good move.
I gotta get used to the fucking shredding in this.
To the sideline, he's got the catch, and he kept the feet in bounds. Well done. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Chiefs first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down in bounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Mahomes now to throw.
Oh, I broke free.
Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. Now here's Mahomes. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And unable to connect. The Chicago defensive unit back out there. They're in a somewhat unenviable position here to start the drive with the ball already up near midfield. Here's Edwards-Helaire as they will start on the ground. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Did he smell good? He got my ass. You saw that?
12 yards into Kansas City first.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together.
Break up. Thank you. I think that's a holding.
Taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So that flag obviously takes away the good yardage that they had on the play.
And talk about a momentum shift because we can visibly see this celebration shifting from one side of the field to the other as soon as everyone saw the flag.
Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. Give him 5 yards there and it'll bring up second down.
This shit is hard.
Mahomes gonna throw. They'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 21. A good pickup there, a 22. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. They move. And they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary. And I think you're exactly right. It wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy and sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. To throw, it's Mahomes. This will be caught at about the six. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone.
I gotta change the camera.
Mahomes finding Juju there for the Kansas City first.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Throwing now is Mahomes. And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. Travis Kelce with career touchdown number 60. And the Chiefs get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point by Butker is on target. And it's now a 7-0 game. So this drive spans 7 plays. And it culminates in a Travis Kelce touchdown. Close throughout. Remember, it was neck and neck at intermission. Neck and
yeah, there's probably a crap ton of dog hair after he took that bath. So I was washing him and I looked at my hands and it was just caked on. I was like, ugh. Goodness.
Okay, I need to see everyone bright and early tomorrow.
This is our defensive coordinator?
Step it up at practice, okay? Bring your A game tomorrow. Let's see it.
I hope not.
Hey! I just want to let you know, the entire staff sees the work you've been putting in. Keep taking advantage of the reps you're getting.
Hey, let's go. Thanks, coach. I will.
Just do yourself a favor. Don't get complacent.
Nah, I'm not. I'm just going to keep building my game.
No wonder everyone's leaving.
There's always another level to be reached, you know?
Exactly. No wonder everyone's leaving.
Now, we just need you to you have all the physical tools, but we are going to put a
lot on this. He's the actor.
Nah, I'm ready. I came here to win.
Good. All camp we've been preaching disruption and chaos. But there's a discipline to all this too. In order to play defense like we want to, it requires constant communication on the field and a dedication to learning the concepts off of it.
Well, I'm dedicated. I'm locked in. I got this playbook with me 24/7.
Now that is what I like to see. I just need you to keep it up. The more comfortable you are with our schemes, the better our defense will be for it. And all season, we'll just keep improving.
I got you, coach. We'll make it happen today.
Okay, let's have a good practice.
That's tough.
It's week 2 of the NFL preseason, where depth charts and playbooks will be put to the test. It's the Bears and the Hawks on Thursday night.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of hard, ain't it? Known for coffee, grunge music, and of course, rain. You're probably like, oh, can you buy me, man? As you look inside a wet and wild Lumen Field.
The Bears defense getting prepared to go to work here in the second week of the preseason.
All right, let's see. So they're in the single back, so. Oh, they got Drew Lock.
They'll start out on the ground with Carson, and he'll get this up just shy of the 30. Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown.
Get a shotgun.
They're setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down. No escape from Locke, and he'll go down. Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured Bear on the field.
Robert Quinn got injured.
But especially here in the preseason, hopefully nothing serious.
Yeah.
Look at him, and we'll step aside for a moment. On third and long, it's Locke. He's going to look deep down the field. He's got a man complete.
What the? You didn't see that?
Freddie Swain, 78 yards. And the Seahawks march right down the field. To claim the early advantage. Well, they spoke about the importance of getting off to a good start, and they're on their first drive, Charles, into the end zone for a touchdown.
I don't know.
Clicking one drive in, didn't need to wait to get up to full speed. We had heard about the extra time they put in with each other, trying to learn each other's skills, what they like, the whole deal, and it paid off. I would expect them to keep firing in the next round and keep that connection going. Out is the Bears defense. They're already down here early as this next drive begins with a first and 10. On first down, Locke. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards. Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive, he comes right back and he's flinging it around really well here. Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. You know, during these preseason games, we're in week two right now, it's always funny looking at our spot charts up here in the booth, because with all the guys that might play in this one, it seems to get bigger and bigger each year.
Yeah, we pretty much supersize them, don't we? Because, you know, remember, they're carrying nine.
Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack. It'll be a loss of 8 on the sack, and it's going to lead him to fourth down.
A good scheme. And an early win for this pass rush.
The Chicago defensive unit back out there. On first and 10, here's Locke. They'll run the screen with Carson. And he is going to lose yardage here. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Here's Locke. A quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating the defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just scared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Deep ball for Goodwin. And that will be incomplete. Scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
I'll tell you what, these last couple of drives, much better from a deep.
Back out is the Bears defense. They trail here in the second quarter as this next drive begins with a first and 10. Here's a handoff to Carson to begin the drive. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. The last run got six, now second and four. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Carson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. The Seahawks on third down, just one for three thus far. This will be third and five. Throwing now is Locke. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
What's your boy's name? Your linebacker's name?
Roquan.
Yeah, is he a middle linebacker?
The Chicago defensive unit back out there. They're back onto the field following
so I just took a spot
a moment ago, so they'll need to get their wits about them quickly here as they set to defend this first and 10. After the turnover, here's Locke. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Lay down.
As we thought they might do here in week two of the preseason, they've left their starting quarterback out there.
What number is he?
But I would imagine we will not see him after halftime.
Yeah, this is the time of year you've got to get your backup some reps and make sure you protect your starting quarterback.
Yeah.
To throw again on second down. Locke. To the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot of times. He was able to get the lead down quickly. He says he can't pass.
Yeah, that's where I'm at right now.
And they can bring up third down now.
To throw his lock.
Oh, he is right there.
It's
a holding penalty. Legal contact.
Seahawks first and 10. Locke gets ready to go.
Right at the 30.
Look how real that is.
They go back to Carson.
Hey guys, this drive going to be up in the game, helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive,
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up the half, we remind you, we got back to our end with a check-in with Jonathan Coachman. Back in our first half, as well as looking ahead to what's coming up later this week.
Okay, Bears, come on. Cook it how you want to cook it, baby. What are you craving? That's cap. Is that why you always make me cook?
Thank you. expect you to win. If you're thinking to go and make money on the run, it's not possible this week. They gotta be checking your brakes. Make sure your brakes are great before you head up. See this? This is my beefsteak.
You might even game plan a little bit.
They got Watson in here. You said I got the shit on hard? Yeah, I got it on all magic. I've been saying that for years.
Because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
And he is going to lose usage here. They're calling a loss of a yard. And that's going to make it fourth down. Meeting the 10th yard zone with a third down. And he's going to break up the Browns' first touch as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. First carry for Nick Chubb.
On me.
Watson has the first down. This is incredible.
All those allegations. Ain't no way. He got his lick back, didn't he?
From the gun, here's Watson.
I wanted to stick him so bad.
On to the second from Cleveland. It's the Browns in control of the football as they go to work on a first and goal.
He was on the Ravens.
Chicago defensive unit back out there.
Ooh, and I got a fumble. I'm gonna force fumble.
What is he doing?
Look at this. Look at all the points. Force a hit kick fumble. Catch one interception. Bye, baby. Look at him.
First and 10. Back to throw, Watson. And that's caught by the tight end, Blaine Wyatt.
And he'll be out after getting the short spot.
That closes up the game. And it's a chance to chase. Up the middle, it's Chubb. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down and out.
Second time, they ain't got a chance. This one's for one.
what?
I'm done listening to these car people.
Done with who?
Huh?
You're done with who?
Listening to these car people.
What are they saying?
I ain't saying nothing. I just looked up how much your car was worth, and I put in a bunch of different shit. Like I tried it a bunch of different ways to see what it would come out to.
Mm-hmm.
Each time. It came out to $34.35 each time. That was the trade. I didn't even look at private party now, but it was the trade.
Yeah, I told him. You see how I caught myself because I was going to tell him how much I owed?
Mm-hmm.
I was going to be like, I'll discuss that once we get closer to it. Making a deal?
Had the nerve to say 25. I even priced it like in worse condition than what it's in, and it still came up to over 30.
Mm-hmm.
And then I priced it with just everything standard and all that, and it still came up to over 30.
Yeah, I'm gonna make him take the whole loan. I was like, 37? I was like, I'm not selling it for less than 35. And then $300 rollover.
I want to go less than 34 at all.
I was like, I know y'all can flip a profit.
It's like 6 grand.
You're the one that's pissed off at you. I don't know why you're looking at him. Yeah, that's it. Uncomfortable, ain't it? What you get.
There it is. I was like,
I don't want to hear it. He's not gonna help you. No, he's not. It's your fault. I don't care. It's your fault. You're the one that pooped in there. Nobody else pooped in there, and you pooped in there. And I took you out this morning, right before you went up. Yeah, I did. I don't care. I don't care. It's your fault. Hey, why don't you have you like this?
I have no idea.
It's your fault, so you gotta deal with it. So lay down. Lay down. I deal with that every single day. Lay down. I don't care if it's uncomfortable. Shouldn't have pooped on your bed then. Yeah. Your man plays like Mario Davis. Mm. Is he cold or something?
Pro bowler.
No, he's sitting over there with attitude now. He didn't even lay down. Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh. Week one.
Yeah. Y'all losing. Sorry. Oh, so you was just playing preseason?
No.
Preseason?
All right, now.
It's week one of the 2022 season, and it's presented by EA Sports. It's the 49ers and the Bears, coming up next.
All right, now.
People just think of that so.
Caught the fumble! Yeah! I just smoked this fucking quarterback. Safety. I have a PS5. Oh man, this would have been another fumble. Elijah Mitchell got lucky there. Oh, I got an X Factor. Woohoo! Get off of me, lineman! No. Nice. How'd I miss?
Now Lance
completes it to the tight end Kittle. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Lance finding Kittle first down San Francisco.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength to occupy some space to guide people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his football.
Turns out to be a reach.
He may be in 10 to goes downfield to get there. And now they'll throw for Lance. This was hot clock hit. Touchdown, Niners. George Kittle, a 22-yard touchdown.
Mitchell. And an
nice move will yield nothing as he sits on the ground. And the inning starts right after that long yard gain back on first down. Shots out of the base kicks from Shannon. It's for Shannon. This to break on from Gordon. The kick by Gold is good. And they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So he went on the sideline for his first chance in the ball game, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there. A big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net.
The Chicago defensive unit back out there.
Kiss. I guess all of this against me. They don't want to start stirring up the conflict. Trying to make it out like I'm expected.
What is he uncomfortable? Everybody's asking, did you get that? Did you get that? I'm like, I'm about to. They're like, bro, you need to get that over your scat. Yeah. I think people like Deeps a lot more than other people think.
We have to set the tone right in the beginning, and they do the exact opposite.
Second down and goal. Jackson got his tight end. That's complete. That's Andrews. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson hooking up with Mark Andrews. And the Ravens go down the field in just two plays to take the early lead. Tucker with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Kick it away following the touchdown. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. First and 10 here for Trubisky and the Steelers.
At their own 25-yard line. A handoff to Harris to begin the drive.
And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test them early. But it proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a 3rd and 8. And he's got his target, Harris. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. They give them a gain of 37. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. Throwing here, Trubisky. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
Trubisky's throw there, hauled in by Claypool. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 18. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. They'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
From the 16, Trubisky. And it's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on 3rd down.
This will be the 8th play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7. From the gun, it's Trubisky. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And the Steelers are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Now a 1st down carry for Harris. Pushing and fighting his way in for a Steeler touchdown. Najee Harris, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Steelers are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Extra point put through by Boswell. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped it to 14. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. A lot of time for this unit to game plan on the sideline after that drive that they watched the other side just score. But remember, last time they were out, they scored as well. We'll see if they can seize that momentum right back.
And they have had a lot of time to cool off from reaching the end zone the last time. So have they been able to keep themselves mentally sharp and into this game, even though they haven't been on the field? And you and I both know, one big play, though, gets them right back up to that level.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. That one covers 24 yards. It's a 1st down. Now Jackson taps this forward, jet sweep. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. On second down, a run with Dobbins. Back-to-back one-yard runs here, so that leaves them with a third down and 8.
But now they're in a spot that every team tells us when we have our production meetings they don't want to be in, third and long. And that's because those back-to-back running plays just didn't accomplish a whole lot.
On third down, Jackson. And he is going to go down. He will be sacked on the final play of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after one. Fourth down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. Back deep is Gunnar Olszewski. This is taken at the 10. A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I'd warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out. But I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Now it's Trubisky. The throw for Claypool is intercepted. Picked up by Marcus Williams. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll start by running the option to the right. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Play action. Now Jackson. And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end, Andrews. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. Davis will take this into the end zone. It's a Ravens touchdown. Oh, CD, there didn't seem to be much resistance there down near the goal line.
Yeah, partner, from what I saw there, not a real good job of matching up defensively, because to me, they looked like they were just in their base 3-4 package. You need bigger bodies in there in a goal line type situation. The 3-4 flying between the 20s, but not down here when you're guarding your end zone.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
Been a little bit of an interesting start. The first drive for him, Charles, they had the passing touchdown. The second drive, he threw the interception. So we'll see what this third drive of the ball game brings.
Yeah, it's kind of a tiebreaker, isn't it? I mean, that's a tough part for them and for him because, yeah, things went really well in that first one, not so well on the second one. He wants to get back to what he did to get this game going.
To throw once more on second and 10. Trubisky. And this one is incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They forced incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
On third down, Trubisky. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Right, help me out here a little bit, partner, because what I'm seeing is a passing game that's just struggling to complete anything. No rhythm, no timing. Seems like every pass is also contested well, so give some credit to the defense.
Fourth down, here's Trubisky. He's going to wind up and air it out. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A surprising move to go for, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. On first and 10, it's Dobbins. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. They go play action now. Jackson into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And the Steelers are going to take over at their own 2-yard line.
Well, Brandon, as they say in popular culture, this one's going to leave a mark because they can see the end zone, but it'll stay out of reach because of their error. All their offensive teammates have to give the quarterback right now, offer a little bit of encouragement because what's done is done. Let's get him next time out.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder coming up in a couple of minutes' time, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman, the coach in our EA Sports studios. He'll have a look back at the next-gen stats from this first half of action. On 2nd and 7, Trubisky. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Here's Trubisky to throw. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 21-7. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Back to the air, Trubisky after the pick six. He's going to air one out. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Kyle Hamilton picks it.
I'm not sure that the wheels, Charles, are coming completely off, but they're shaking a little bit. That's 3 interceptions, and now interceptions here on back-to-back drives.
And I think about what a Hall of Fame coach told me that he always told his teams, when a mistake happens, just move on to the next play. Let it go. Hard to do when you're throwing this many interceptions. That's exactly the attitude that has to be adopted.
Looking for Bateman. He's got him complete.
Call it a gain of 6 on the play. And now 2 yards to go on third down. They go play action with Jackson.
And that's going to be caught. It's James Prochet.
And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
He's going to go for a big play downfield. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. Here's Jackson. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, they got him again. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
They'll try and throw for it with Jackson. And he's got his tight end. That's Andrews. And he will have a first down as they're into field goal range now at the 30. So first and 10 now from the 30. Jackson. And inside the 20 before it's brought down. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Both teams going back through their game plans, making their final halftime adjustments. And for the call of the second half, we go back up to Baltimore and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. DuVernay now going to bring it out. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. And I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation and pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
And not a whole lot to speak of there, so bring him down shy of the 20. Well, come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Oh, looking for Andrews downfield. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Mark Andrews, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Ravens have moved out in front by 3 touchdowns.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Tucker with the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing. And try and get back to where you were to start the half.
And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
Really out for blood this time, look. I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Gonna tell a friend to tell a friend. They say success is the best.
that's revenge. Heard they was sleeping again, say it no more. This is a rude awakening, kicking the door. Back and I'm better than ever before. Don't get it mistaken, I'm ready for war. I see the odds and I'm up in the score. I catch a and jump in the course. Follow the core and I'm back to the morgue. Take the sheet off and I some more. When I'm your done at the scene, I won't leave anything. You won't even know who was involved. Don't let me do it, cause I overdo it and do it till I cannot do it no more. All of the data's, I'm proving them wrong.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. That's to about the 28. Second down coming up.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Brady gonna throw. Getting it out wide here to Bernard. 7 yards there and a first down.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. In this case, he picks up a first down.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. Again, here's Bernard. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
I really like the vision he displayed on that play because he saw there wasn't a lane to completely break off a huge gain. So he found where there was the most space and got what he could. A nice dirty run. That's a positive play for the offense.
And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Fournette running out of the gun. And across midfield he goes into Raven territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
First down, Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people, but you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
And he'll fight forward on the straight-ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down. On play action, it's Brady. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
They've gobbled up over 30 yards of turf so far, but a sack knocks them backwards. And that interrupts the momentum they were building. Good opportunity for the defense to escape this drive before they get to the end zone.
So Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic. Third and long after that last sack. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. They may have thrown the interception. Obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shot and throw it away. What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
We're scoreless after one. They run the option here on first and 10.
And he is going to lose yardage here.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. That's complete. Left side to Bateman. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. First and goal. A chance to convert that early turnover into points. They'll run with Dobbins. And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7.
Not a whole lot there on first and goal, and that's what you're looking for defensively. You'll certainly live with giving up just a yard or two in this situation.
They go option right on second and goal. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson. Keeping it himself from 7 yards out. And the Ravens post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. The PAT up and good, but hold on a second. There is a flag. And they'll accept that penalty. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. From the 31, Brady looking for Godwin again, and he's got him once more. A 6-yard pass on back-to-back plays. Picks up the first. Here's Brady to throw. He's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. First down is Brady. Going for Evans, but that pass is intercepted. picked off by Marlon Humphrey. Trotty! And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player so as the ball hits his hands, and off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Kyle Hamilton picks it. And he will not get all the way.
I'm really, really out for blood this time. Look. Just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Gonna tell a friend to tell a friend. They say success is the best revenge. Heard they were sleeping again, say it no more. This is a rude awakening, kicking the door. Back and I'm better than ever before. Don't get it mistaken, I'm ready for war. I see the ice and I'm up in the score. I catch a and jump in the course. Follow the core and I'm back to the morgue. Take the sheet off and I some more. When I am done at the scene, I won't leave anything. You won't even know who was involved. Don't let me do it, cause I overdo it and do it till I cannot do it no more. All of the data's, I'm proving them wrong. Back with the classic, I know it's been long.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Los Angeles Chargers and the Baltimore Ravens. Set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. Here's Eckler to begin the drive. And right away they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Back to throw here, Herbert. Got this to Williams, complete. And they worked this well upfield across the 45. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. Herbert setting up to throw on first down. And that's incomplete.
Well, sometimes the defense just beats you. Great coverage from the secondary, all of them in the proper position. So instead of trying to throw into tight coverage, he found a way to throw it away and come back and try again the next down.
To throw on second and 10, Herbert. It's caught inside the 25. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Running on first down, Eckler. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
They've created a nice sustained drive off of plays like that. A nice strong run there that keeps them advancing the ball.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. A doubtful young man to show off the pass rush skills.
They talk about rhythm breaker right there. They've been moving the ball well. Drive it started beautifully. That one's going to hurt.
The seventh play now of this opening drive. This is third and long, though. Here's Herbert. Man open left side is Williams. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
Nice job understanding the situation. Third and long. Kept the play in front of them and made the tackle. They gave up a good chunk of yardage, but it does force a fourth down.
They snap it to Herbert. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The fourth down play doesn't work for the Chargers. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And he'll maybe get it back to the 25 here on the first play, but no more than that. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Off the play fake to Dobbins. Here's Jackson. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. 16 yards on that one at a Raven first.
That is definitely what we call our defense an auto play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson. When you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
On second down and 4, Jackson. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Busts like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 32-yard line. A gain of 22. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 32-yard line. Now it's Jackson. He's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
Jackson, draw play to Dobbins. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. The 22 is the line to gain here on third down. Throwing is Jackson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Tucker's kick is good. And the Ravens strike first at 3-0. So a pretty good opening drive. That'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted 6, but they got 3 in the early lead.
And they should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope that good things are in store here today for them.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Charger drive about to get going. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field, and he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit from the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two. Here's Herbert. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Adafe Owe. That is now two sacks for him here in this first half.
These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles. And that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out, because the entire game he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
A big kick that time, 52 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Just a couple on the ground there. That's going to bring up third and about six. Here's Jackson to throw. Open man is Bateman. It's complete. And he will have the Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Second quarter. 2 minutes remain. 3-0 our score. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coaches. Two-minute drill.
Jackson's throw into the hands of Andrews. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here, because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock, because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. Fourth down, here's Jackson. That's caught left side by the tight end, Boyle. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Here's Jackson. And that'll be taken in by Andrews for a Ravens touchdown. It's a 6-yard touchdown pass, and the Ravens will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Tucker with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, the pressure, the hits, the sacks have been coming at him all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for him to throw it or maybe change what they do on offense.
Yeah, that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now. Rolling to his left, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. So it's third and long, and defensively, not a real surprise there in the dime. Herbert. And unable to connect, incomplete. Give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
That's pulled in at the 32. A nice return that time, gets 12 yards back. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
Both teams going back through their game plans, making their final halftime adjustments. And for the call of the second half, we go back up to Baltimore and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They'll start by running the option to the right. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second. To throw is Jackson. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he's as fine with that incompletion as a quarterback can be, in all honesty. He avoided his first sack of the game, and he did have a chance of connecting for yardage, just unable to on that throw.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's caught. It's DeMarcus Robinson. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. On first and 10, it's Jackson. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get, taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
Jackson on the give to Dobbins. And he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers 44. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Yards. It's They're going on fourth down. It's Jackson, and he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Ravens go for it, but come up empty. And that will force a turnover on downs. On first down, Justin Herbert. He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Herbert on first down now. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sack back of the 29. Justin Houston picks up his second sack of the afternoon. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. Got an open man. It's Josh Palmer. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Everyone's eyes go to him when he nears the end zone, and that includes the coverage, who took away the easy throwing lanes and forced a high throw.
Herbert jogs off, and out comes Dustin Hopkins to take this kick for L.A. on fourth down. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. And that is going to be no good. He pushed it wide to the right, and they will not cut into that 10-point lead. Well, close game, second half. You obviously hate to leave three out on the field.
Especially in a game like this when you know points are hard to come by. That was one of their best opportunities so far, and they come away with nothing.
There he goes, right side. The 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. It's a scintillating run by Lamar Jackson. And the Ravens are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And that makes our score 17-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. The Charger drive about to get going.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback,
rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it up.
Chasing three women like I'm Mojo Jojo. So my girl got mad and she my bro. Monica, you're wrong, though. That's against a bro code. Headed to his home, though. No, we living solo. Vertebrae, vertebrae.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Buffalo Bills and the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Tackling they want to see all game as he'll lose yardage to start things out. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. That was off kilter. Offense up front, everyone was just kind of out of sync.
Well, from my perspective, that certainly looked like the defense just destroyed that play. Absolutely just took it over.
All right, so I'm going to revamp what I said. The defense was in sync. How about that?
Oh, I like that one.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he gets all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A big play here for Buffalo. 59 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And he's got his tight end Knox for a Bills touchdown. From 19 yards away. And the Bills are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. Three plays already in the end zone. That was quick.
We always talk about offenses understanding what they want to do before they go into a game, and they practice it. They have their script and the plays they want to open with. But defenses aren't just reactive. They have their own ideas as well. These ideas didn't get implemented very well. Three plays and a touchdown already scored against them.
Here's the Bills kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at about the 32. They'll start with the option. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. The first play of the drive, lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Throwing on second and 14, Jackson. That's for Bateman, and it's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick, and he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
And, Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And this will go as a gain of seven as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
Extra receivers will spread the defense out, and they're able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. Good job. They go right back to Singletary. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one.
If they're going to get a first down out of this, they're going to have to earn it because there's been tough going in the interior there. And here we are on third and one. Be prepared. Brace yourself. There'll be some contact going on.
Allen now on the sneak. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. A false start backs him up five, first and 15. Now this time, Allen will throw. That's going to be caught. Touchdown, Bills. Dawson Knox with his second touchdown of this opening quarter.
And the Bills lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. Extra point by Bass, up and good.
And it's now 14-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. It's a squib kick that still makes its way down inside the 15.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line set to get going. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. Tremaine Edmonds there to bring him down. Play action. Now Jackson. And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown.
Charles, it is pretty rare that we see a team build this kind of lead in the opening quarter. And, man, they seem to be clicking on all three phases right there. The defense doing its part with a pick six.
And it's absolutely been the definition of a start that you would pick for yourself and for your team, right? And I have a feeling that they just want to stay in this zone. What's truly incredible about this start is they can add on a couple more scores. This one could legitimately be over in the second quarter.
So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away.
Squib kick picked up near the 20.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ball game as they come up first and 10. The throw here to Andrews, the tight end. Unable to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
I have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
They'll run up the gut with Dobbins.
And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. Now it's Jackson.
That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, these guys certainly need something good to go their way because this first quarter has been something of a disaster for them trying to move the ball. But that completion there maybe can get them focused and moving in the right direction.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
A shotgun snap and a give to Dobbins.
Now the ball comes loose. Now this is picked up by the Bills. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. And a little careless there, Charles, on that carry.
And it's not just having two hands on the ball. It's tucking it away. It's using your body to keep people shielded off. It's so many different things into taking care of it and having ball security. In that case, though, we didn't see it happen.
Singletary to get the drive started, and he'll be taken down. To the end of the first quarter of play. The Bills with a football as we start quarter number two, as they're looking at a second down and nine to go. It's Johnson, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Throwing is Allen on third. And this is intercepted. He was trying to get it to Davis. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
Boy, a big play right there. I mean, a touchdown on this drive could have really put some separation on the scoreboard. Instead, it's the defense who scores. And, partner, we got a game again.
And we do have one because of what you just described. The defense had understood what was going on in this game and did something about it. They knew their offense needed some help. They just provided it. They're back in this one.
McKenzie will not return this and will be brought out to the 25.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Now Allen to try again after the pick six. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Allen going to throw. Out to the left. He's got his tight end Knox. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Allen and Knox teaming up there for Buffalo first down.
So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
On first down, Allen. Going right back to Knox, and again a completion. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. Calling a gain of three on the play, and it'll be second down.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. Throwing again on second down. Allen. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Running from the gun, Johnson. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Again, it's Johnson. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. A first down carry here for Johnson. And he'll wind up getting about six out of that, as that's going to lead us to the two-minute warning. It's a six-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. And now they'll throw with Allen. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. With the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
To Johnson again, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Duke Johnson, a three-yard touchdown run, and the Bills take a three-touchdown lead. The extra point by Bass, up and good, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. Here's the Bills kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. Kicks it on the ground with a squib, taken around the 28. And he takes it all the way across the 40 before going out of bounds.
Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass, and that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Now Dobbins again on second down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. On third down, Jackson. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. And what a return as he brings this one all the way back to the 25-yard line.
Well, there are several factors at play for why they face this deficit right now, Charles, but that's now three interceptions that he has thrown and just giving the football away. Pretty careless here in the opening half.
Yeah, I know that all of our parents taught us to share as youngsters, but in this game, you don't want to share with the other team. Keep it for yourself. Keep it for your team. Got to cut down on all of those throws, those errant passes.
Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Kyle Hamilton picks it. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Past the 20. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
Coaches preach all the time about opportunities and taking advantage of them, and he did exactly that. I used to have a coach told us all the time, a lost opportunity is never regained. Well, no regrets here. He picked that one off and took it to the house.
Boy, still a half plus to play, but it is a two-score game. They're going to go onside kick early. And the Bills are going to recover. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So we've reached the intermission in what right now is a 13-point game. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. It's a squib kick fielded just inside the 20. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape up past the 30. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Here's Jackson on third and long. Steps away to his left. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And they'll be inside the red zone with a ball at the 16-yard line.
Hey, I'm all about defense forcing plays and getting takeaways. But an interception and two fumbles in their last three offensive possessions.
Time to readjust.
Yeah, you can't just give all the credit to the defense on that. They've got to look in the mirror and take the blame themselves and figure out how to not do it anymore.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Ball sits on the 10, second and five. Back to the ground, this time Cook. The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal. Cook will get about halfway there as he takes this from the 4 down to the 2. From the 2 now, second and goal. Cook is going backwards as he'll be tackled back at the 4-yard line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down.
I think we got to give it up for him right there. That's a heck of an athletic move for a big man right in the middle of the line. How about the play he makes there? Nowhere to run, and he finishes that one off for a loss.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Singletary, and he is going to lose yardage here. So they're going for it, and here's Allen. And he is going to be out of bounds, well short of the pylon, and that will be a turnover on downs. Well, you feel the excitement build on those fourth down plays. Defense has to stay out there, but for the offense, when that thing doesn't work out, such disappointment.
It can absolutely be a deflator, but how about the defensive guys? If they stop you on fourth down, they are absolutely elevated going to their bench.
They're elevated now. Big stop on fourth down. Here's Davis to run again on second. Able to break the tackle and get some breathing room before being brought down just outside the 5. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Jackson to throw. And he's got his tight end. That's Andrews. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson. Yet again, targeting and finding Mark Andrews. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. They go play action now, Jackson. The improvisation gets him only a couple, but that's all they needed. First down.
As he came to the line of scrimmage, he knew he didn't need much to reset the chain, so when he saw the space he needed, no hesitation. He went to the marker and got his guys a first down.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. A give up the middle to Dobbins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 49-yard line. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
On second and 10, Jackson being chased out left. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against with the Eagles, and I believe it's against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Singletary again. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction. Makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
No daylight for him to run through there. And he ran into the defensive tackle. And that guy blocks a whole lot of daylight as it is. He is truly a big man who just made a big play.
And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. Big hook up there, forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
Johnson. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. They'll give up the middle to Johnson. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Now a handoff. Johnson. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a 3rd and about 4 for a first.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. Allen now looks to throw.
He'll get this out wide to Singletary.
Touchdown! Devin Singletary from 4 yards out. And the Bills have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Allen will try to throw for it. And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack. And they fail on the try for 2. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a squib kick fielded just inside the 20. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
The Ravens take over Chris Denzias at their own 28-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
Well, probably not much that they can do at this point, CD. Down three scores late in the fourth quarter. This is going to be a little too much to overcome, you would think.
Yeah, they'll go down swinging, but in the end, I think we saw the writing on the wall a while back because one team was clearly better than the other in this one. And while it didn't quite reach blowout status, I think we knew who was going to win this one well before we got to this stage.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson dancing to his left. And he's going to lose a yard or two, taken down behind the line. That's sacked by Tremaine Edmonds.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailed by multiple touchdowns and a late sack. Just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the locker room with him.
Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Credit the sack to Von Miller. Now after that sack, it's third and long for Jackson in the run. Oh, he fakes a spike. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and it'll be a turnover on downs. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. On first down, they'll start out with Singletary. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll run out of the gun with Singletary. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down. On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Yeah, this is the biggest bitch I've ever played against. He's the motherfucker that plays the D-line and just puts everybody in zone. Straight up. I don't understand how the Bills can shred off blocks that quick. They're not even top 10 in run defense. They literally got torched by fucking KC. Like, it was an air raid. Like, what the fuck? Shit's bogus as hell. I just really wish you could rematch in this game. Oh, thank God. I love playing the Cowboys. Because everybody's going to blame Dak.
And the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Baltimore Ravens and the Dallas Cowboys. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away, and we are underway from AT&T Stadium. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, and he opted for the touchback.
Calling no gain, and they get his first play, and it's second down now.
I do not think he's going to throw that. God, break free one time. Who's this big fucking fullback? This dude's taking a whole quarter to score. Maybe a first down. Let's go.
just a simple tap pass,
and sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. And that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and just keeps getting in motion.
He can rank up those tackles and punches in the run game from that middle linebacker spot.
And what he has to do is make sure he congratulates the guys in front and tells them thanks a lot, because as the guy in the middle, the Michael linebacker, you're counting your front three, your front four,
Damn. Micah Parsons?
Play action. Now Jackson. That ball caught. It's Nick Andrews, the tight end.
That shit weird as hell.
And taking it across midfield, it's just the 45. So from Cowboy territory, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Another run here with Dominic. DeMarcus Lewis has the tackle.
Yeah, everybody stacked up here in the middle. Bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, you're fortunate to get anything out of that.
Second and 9 from the 40.
That's a house call, baby! Fucking fast ass. This dude fast as hell. Should I try it? Yeah, I'm gonna try it. Fuck it. Oh! Golly.
Now it's Jackson.
Yikes. Took forever for that play to develop.
Give him six on the screen, but now it's still going.
out for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Both teams making their final preparations for the second half of six. So with that, let's get you back to Arlington, where we rejoin Brandon and Charles.
Welcome you back now, alongside Charles Harris, running, getting six for quarter number three here. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, seven-seven on the score. And this will not be returned to the end zone for a touchback. The Ravens set the last week's touchdown.
Oh, he's going for strips now. Okay, bet. Come on, hold your blocks, man.
The
Dallas offense is here to begin the drive.
Thank God. I was about to say.
Touchdown,
You want to hear what he's saying?
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be two?
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Marcus Williams. All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to 7. If we made one more play, could have had our shutout.
Now Jackson. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson, 37 yards. And the Ravens have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to them.
And Prescott, his 3rd interception. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he will bring this back. It's a pick 6 and a Raven touchdown. Tucker now to add the point after. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, CD, it's all window dressing at this point. I mean, the best they can do is end the game with a nice drive to maybe build some momentum to move forward into their next contest.
Yeah, with how lopsided this game has been, even one score might not do a lot of cosmetic good on the scoreboard, partner, because it's just about looking forward at this point. Get a touchdown here, give yourself some positive momentum and reps to focus on when you get back to practice in the next couple of days.
A second down throw for Prescott. And this one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football. Nearly a 4th pick of the ball game.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. For this defense, CeeDee, that's kind of the icing on the cake here as we get to the end of this one.
And didn't you feel that they weren't just going into total prevent there? You know, they had the lead, and sometimes you fall back and you lose your aggressiveness. Not in this case. They were still making a play on the football, and look how that one turned out. They may have salted this one away.
And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Oh, Jackson's going to throw it to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do.
Jackson hit, and he lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. Down the numbers. There he goes. The 40. The 20. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys.
Yeah, so hold the phone here, Charles. I've kind of written him off, but after that touchdown, certainly a long way still to go, but stranger things have happened.
Well, when you're going to have big second-half comebacks, plays like that have to be involved.
The extra point is good, but it only impacts the final score as this game comes to a close. Well, on the one side, if you try to take away something positive from this game, they played to the final whistle, getting the touchdown there on the last.
Whew, that was fun. I'm going to go look at my record, and then I'm going to switch this stream over to some Call of Duty with the pregnant old lady. See how many kills it takes for me to rage to the center of the Tootsie Pop. I don't even know if that made sense. Look how many people are playing with the Chargers. One, two. Look at the top 100. Look, Chargers. There ain't no way he's played over 300 games already. Who has the highest win streak? 7-game win streak? Sheesh! That's the dude. That's the dude I played. That was using the Bills?
Number two?
Yes!
You played number two?
Yes! That's the dude I played with the Bills that played like a bitch. Oh, I see.
You played the number two right dude.
And I lost it by 2 touchdowns to him.
And you're right in that from the third one. Why would that make you play against the second right dude?
Oh my god, I'm putting that on Snapchat. That's tough.
That first guy's really on Twitch.
Only? Holy
this
crap.
Said 3 days ago, he said, number one ranked head-to-head player. And in parentheses, he said won't be on long. He's trained for 7 hours.
Jeez.
That won't be on long. Oh, yeah, he's... He's probably played that many games. Because before this 7 hour long one, he played 13 and a half hours.
He's bogus as hell for playing that long. All right, I'm switching over to Call of Duty. I'll be on in about 5 minutes.